It's great to welcome back to the microphone Shelley Simpson, and she is the Executive Vice President, Chief Commercial Officer, President of Highway Services at J.B. Hunt Transport, and she's been extremely busy as of late. She was in Seattle last week talking with folks, and now she's in the city of Atlanta with us here at FreightWaves, and it's really good to see you.
So thrilled to be here, Mark. Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. You know, it's really a lot of fun. I was watching the announcement yesterday coming down about what's going on with the new product line that J.B. Hunt is offering, the J.B. Hunt 360 box that is going to be coming out this summer, and just watching reaction from a lot of the folks that were in the press parties and some of the conversation going on. You guys have got really a lot of good stuff coming up.
You know, we're so excited, Mark. It just it reminded me last night when we had our launch party of the 360 box. It really reminded me so much of that innovation that Mr. Hunt really pushed us on in the entrepreneurship. And, you know, it's interesting. I just had a talk around who says innovation is only for startups.
Yes, right, right.
And, you know, using our legacy of who we are and listening to our customers, but also listening to our carriers and drivers and what their interest in moving forward, Mark, has been fantastic. We're excited.
Yes.
It's a brand new program, but you know what? We really think that's going to help create a more efficient transportation network, and that is our focus inside JBN 360.
I do want to get into a lot of that because this is really groundbreaking, to say the very least. I do want to mention also the fact that you were one of the speakers here at the FreightWaves convention. I know there was a lot of folks that were there listening to some of your comments. Talk about that, and especially some of the stories about Craig Harper.
Well, so, you know, one of the questions that I got was, you know, how do you disrupt or innovate in such a large company? You know, I can't remember exactly what he called us, but he just said it were such a behemoth and very difficult to move and change directions.
Right.
And I talked a lot about, you know, I worked for Craig Harper, our CEO, for 10 years. That was really good for me because
for people
that know me know I have a lot of passion about what I work on. And sometimes that passion can be a little too much passion there, Mark. And Craig's very famous in our organization for having what we call ice cream talks.
Oh, okay.
And
those are
when your passion have maybe gotten the best of you, when you're trying to really push on something to change. And when I see something I feel like should be changed or just isn't right, I can become very passionate about that. And I remember one time sitting in my office after I felt like people just weren't getting the change and the innovation we were really trying to move in the company. I was in a small meeting, but I got fairly passionate. And boy, it wasn't 5 minutes later, I had Craig Harper knocking on my door. And, you know, that was my first and only time that he said, hey, I've never got a ride in your car.
Oh, wow.
Would you like to go get some ice cream?
Oh, how fun.
And it was
fun
at that time that I realized sometimes you just need people that can help you see the big picture what you're working on right that second. It is important, but we have to bring people along. We have to educate people.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely.
I have lots and lots of great Craig Harper stories. Not sure I should tell them on stage but or here on air, but I'd be happy to share.
No, absolutely. You know, one of the great things about what you guys have done here at the convention, you've launched what is called the J.B. Hunt 360 box, and that's going to be coming up this summer. And I know there's a lot of press out there about that. A lot of folks are talking about how this is going to be moving the industry. And I was reading some of the material that the pool is going to consist of 500 trailers that businesses can reserve for drop trailer purposes. And this is really a great idea because you would think, okay, there's going to be plans coming up as well that's going to accelerate these available units as time goes along, right? This has got great growth potential.
Great growth potential, Mark. When you look at how large the industry is, you know, we're a large carrier and transportation provider, but the industry is so large in total.
Yeah.
So over $700 billion industry. So we're still very small inside that market. But when we're listening to our customers and talking to our customers as to what they want us to think about, you know, this whole concept around J.B. Hunt 360 box really came as a result of our customers saying, hey, listen, I love what you're doing in J.B. Hunt 360. I love being able to connect into the marketplace with available capacity. However, I really need the efficiency inside my location. And so I need to have a drop and hook trailer, and that kind of birthed the idea of, well, what if we were able to run the JBant 360 box into the marketplace and allow 83% of capacity to really have access to that, where they've really never had access to those very large shippers and shippers that are requiring that. So it's just creating something so different in the market. But one of the things I love most, if you think about it from a carrier perspective, anything that can give them back time to be on the road, be the road driving,
right.
Is going to be a benefit for them, but it's also going to be a benefit for our customers and anyone else that is participating in that type of program. And so you think about a drop trailer program now. Now a carrier can go in, they can drop and hook in 15 minutes, pick up that JB Hunt 360 box, and then get on the road.
They're back out there.
That's exactly right, Mark. And we want to get after that inefficient time that drivers spend. All 3.5 million drivers every single day need more time on the road earning more money.
And talk about, too, the fact that now this is going to really give a lot of the small carriers, a lot of the owner-operators, some really great leverage. I mean, you look at some of the market numbers, like with owner-operators and the smaller carriers, 83% is some of the numbers that I've been reading. So you're talking about bringing in a very large group of trucking industry people into the mix here. It's going to help them be profitable as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, this is freight that has, you've only had access if you had the ability to have the capital to have incremental trailers there at a location for a customer. Or frankly, Mark, it also is to do business with that customer. You might not have all the technology that is needed. You know, a lot of times they require EDI and things to automatically update. You know, when you're a small trucking company,
very difficult
to meet every single requirement that a customer really does need to run their business, but difficult to do as a small carrier. Really, our 360 platform allows them the technology to connect, but 360 box allows them a brand new market that they can have access to, and we're really excited. We're excited for the carrier community, our customers, but honestly, Mark, we're excited about our own drivers and what that can mean to our own company drivers and our employees and what we think 360 can do to revolutionize transportation.
Well, when you sent out the press release, you did that yesterday, as a matter of fact, I would imagine you got a lot of instant feedback from your drivers themselves.
Absolutely.
What did you hear?
Well, first we tried to educate all of our employees to understand, for us, we're inefficient also, Mark. As a large carrier such as ourselves, you know, you think about the one-third of hours completely wasted in either idle or running empty. It just doesn't make any sense with where technology is today. And you know what? We experience the same thing. We experience that as a large carrier. And so what happens is the more shipments that we can see, you start to think about, Mark, pouring billions of dollars of shipments into JB Hunt 360. That's made available to all capacity, all 3.5 million drivers, including our own drivers. So we want to eliminate the same thing that we're doing contract carriers. We want to do that same thing for our own employees. So if they're a driver on the road, we don't want them to sit. We want to give them a load that will utilize their available time and allow them to be on the road. And growing that platform allows us to do that, too.
I would imagine, too, that keeping track of all of these trailers and all of the components that go along with this, that the new trailers are going to be equipped with technology that is going to be able to keep, to be able to show where they are, what they're doing. In other words, it's going to provide end-to-end load tracking and monitoring, which is really going to be good for folks.
Which is going to be fantastic, because now we can say, hey, this is where the trailer is. It's loaded.
Yep.
It's ready. We contact the customer, and it's ready to execute inside JB Hunt 360. So a carrier or a driver gets the ability to see that shipment, selects on it. They can book it straight through, and it's pretty seamless for them as well.
I'm looking at this as well. Didn't the company complete the installation of tracking technology on all 10,000 100,000, I should say, plus company trailers and containers back last year.
That's right. So we did, it was about an 18-month effort. And so we really believe that connecting the network of capacity is really critical for us to drive waste out, including our own capacity. So we really took an 18-month timeline to be able to integrate Orbcomm into every one of our containers and over-the-road trailers. And that also has enabled us to say, you know what? Part of the empty time for our company drivers mm-hmm. is looking for an empty. You know, right, think about right, how silly right. that is. You know, how many times have you gotten lost looking for your car in the parking lot? Right. Well, nowadays, there's an app that, you know, it'll just pop it to you
right,
to tell you where your car is. Very similar concept. But being able to satellite track all of those trailers, Mark, as we add those trailers now for JBant 360, we've got experience in it now, and now we can tell a carrier exactly where to go, where to get their next trailer, and to be moving on inside 360.
You know, one of the main components, Shelley, the fact that we are here at the FreightWaves convention, there's been a lot of talk about technology, where it's going to be moving the industry going forward, and the platforms that you're describing are going to help it get to that level. But I would think back in the office monitoring, that tracking, all of that, that's going to require infrastructure, that's going to require people that are going to be trained in this, and they're going to be able to assist the drivers, the companies that are out there on the road, with the efficiency of being able to help them. I've got questions here. We got folks back home that can answer those questions.
Oh, boy, did you hit the nail on the head for us, because we don't just believe in technology. We think technology will enable great relationships.
Absolutely.
It will eliminate the monotonous, the things, Mark, that none of us enjoy doing. If you think about it, and you're on the road, and you just want to know something more about the load before you book the load,
right.
or just more about a facility, you're not going to have to get on the phone to find out that information, get on hold, look for the right person.
Right.
It's just waste that's not necessary. You can do that straight from your mobile app, and that changes their ability to just execute and do exactly what we said, drive more.
You mentioned at the beginning of the program there's going to be like 500 trailers to get started, and one of the questions I saw up on Facebook overnight, are these trailers going to be strategically positioned, say, in the west or in the northwest, southeast? How is the deployment going to go with that?
So it's been interesting, Mark. So anytime that you start a new program, we definitely have talked to a base set of our customers that are piloting those with us. But let me tell you that I've had many customers since our announcement reach out and say, listen, I want to be engaged, and can we look at these specific areas? Now, that's going to help us think about what our growth plan can look like. We know the 500 trailers that are slotted and ready to go into production, and we've worked with our customers on that, but we are talking to customers right now because we certainly don't think 500 trailers is near enough for what we think the opportunity is to drive that efficiency in total. But I will tell you this also, you know, it's been really interesting. I have had many carriers send me a note.
Okay.
That said, listen, how do I get signed up? Who can I contact? I would like to do shipments from, you know, A to B, and I'm available this often on a per week or per day basis. And so that's been really great. Even here at the conference, some carriers coming up and saying, listen, this is a game changer for us
too.
Because now we can drop and hook. They know that's a different type of freight that is more efficient, and how do we get access to that? So I've got both sides.
Sure.
That's been really great to have those conversations.
And I'm looking at this too. You mentioned the drop and hook, the ability then getting back out on the road. That's also got to be good news as far as the safety factor is concerned, because drivers that are waiting around, they're trying to maybe find out where the next load's going to go to. They may be waiting at a shipper, for example, for a long period of time. In and out quickly, they're back on the road. That's going to be safer for that driver. They're going to be less fatigued because of the efficiency of what you're describing.
You know, great point. I think one of the things that we are hoping to help all drivers, so drivers that run for JB Hunt and also drivers that are with contract carriers, we want to give them more information so that they can actually plan their route, plan their day, know what to expect, Mark, when they go into a facility. So we're on version 4 of our Carrier 360 app.
Okay.
And inside that version, Mark, they're going to get access, if they are a gold or silver member on the 360 platform, they're going to get access to the customer name. They're going to get access to 9 different amenities. They're going to get access to what's the rating at that location? And here's the big one, in my opinion, what are the comments from other drivers?
Yes, yes.
That, by the way, are not scrubbed outside of the dirty words. So we're going to do something about those words, but fill in the blank where we blank that out.
Sure, sure.
But you know what? It comes down to a level of trust. And it comes down to a level of, I want to be able to plan for what I'm going into. So now, if I go into a facility, and I'm a silver member on JBET 360, now I can see, oh, okay, I'm going into Kimberly-Clark at this location.
Yep.
It has 4 stars.
You know what to expect.
I can overnight park.
Yes, yes.
I know it takes 42 minutes to load. I now start to understand, and you know what I start doing, Mark? I start thinking about my day differently.
When you were looking at this, say, from 10 years ago, when you first got started in the industry a number of years back, this is like a game changer night and day. When you look at some of the efficiencies in the system over maybe 10, 15 years to where we are now, we are really moving in a technology-driven platform that's really going to help make things a whole lot easier. And that's the name of the game. And when I look at JB Hunt 360, that's your baby.
Well, it is my baby.
It's your baby.
You know, on the 25th of this month, I'll celebrate my 25th anniversary.
Oh, congratulations.
And
right,
well,
right.
Thank you. But when I look back, you know, I've had the opportunity to work in almost all of our segments. I grew up on the asset part of our business.
Right.
And then I've spent about the last half of my career on both the asset and non-asset part of the business. And things are just changing so much, but they're changing for the better,
good.
Mark.
Sure.
You know, when
sure.
you look at some of the technology now that enables our drivers to be safer,
yes.
and have the ability to just have a better trip down the road, you know, that's making it better for drivers. That's also available to other drivers. But when you think about just that waste, that's the most frustrating. When I talk with carriers and drivers, the most frustrating thing of their day is the things that are outside of their control that, honestly, when I listen to the mark, I always think, oh, well, call me.
Yes.
That's what I always think. Well, everybody can't call on every problem, but technology can help.
Yes.
So, you know,
bridges that gap.
Yeah, that's exactly right. You know what my favorite thing is to do? I had a question about this yesterday, and this is really great. I got the opportunity. We've been collecting ratings about our customers. I got the opportunity to go in front of the C-suite of a very large organization.
Sure.
CEO, COO, you name it. And they wanted to talk to me about how to be a better shipper of choice, which is at the heart of, you know, what I want to help in the industry. But do you know what they said? Hey, can we see our ratings? And of course, I showed them their ratings. There was a facility that was rated fairly poorly. And they said, do you happen to have comments? Now, I had hidden those comments because I wasn't totally sure. And I looked at them and said, well, I actually have the comments, but I haven't cleaned them up. And they said, we want to see them completely raw.
Send it to us. Right.
That very second, you know what happened? The minute they saw it, the COO said, I knew it. I've been hearing feedback on this. We're going to get with that location. The CEO was on it. People don't actually want to treat people
the way
the drivers had given feedback. They didn't want that. Nobody really wants to say, hey, I'd like to treat you really bad today.
No.
But now that we give them access to that information, it gives them power to say, hey, what are you doing to be a better location? And that, to me, is powerful.
I'll be willing to bet you're going to get so much feedback concerning JB Hunt 360 and the new box service that you've got. The growth opportunities are absolutely huge from so many different platforms out there. And based on that feedback, that, I would imagine, is how you're going to grow each of those platforms. This is just the beginning. Mm-hmm. In other words, right? This is not the end of the story for JB Hunt and innovation and technology. There's going to be continual exciting things that are going to be coming down the pike.
Oh, I love that you said it's just the beginning.
Yep.
You know, Mr. Hunt used to say it's going to be a big day. That was his famous quote. I didn't get the opportunity to work directly with him, but, you know, I happened to be married to employee number 545.
Right.
And he tells stories all the time. I get to hear all the legacy stories. But when you think about it's a big day, what is a big day?
Oh, it's a motivator.
What does a big day mean in total? You know, that's what yesterday was. It is just the beginning of a big day, a big time for our organization. When I started with the company, I remember thinking, and this just shows you how, you know, dumb and naive I was and young, and maybe I'm just old, dumb, and naive now, but I remember thinking, wow, I'm going to have to leave this company because they're already a billion-dollar business.
Sure.
It's already big. I wished I had gotten in on the ground floor.
Right.
Now
right.
I look up and
you are on the ground floor.
We've nearly tripled our company in 10 years, Mark.
Wow.
And
yep.
I feel like we're on the ground floor.
What do you think Mr. Hunt would think of his company today?
I can tell you what Mrs. Hunt says.
Okay.
when I see Mrs. Hunt, I'll see her at church or I'll see her just, you know, come into the building. She always says, you guys make me so proud. And if Johnny were here to see that realization, I don't know if anybody's told you this story. It's a great story.
Okay.
But in our corporate campus, there on the bottom floor, that's where all of our computers and security is, and used to have these big mainframes.
Yeah, yeah.
And the story goes, Mr. Hunt used to walk our customers down into that space, and he would say, you see all these machines? Someday, all shipments
will go through there.
We'll go through there, and we're going to create, in other words, create a more efficient network. And I'm like, oh my gosh, that's JB Hunt 360. So I can only imagine.
Right.
And you know what? We think JB Hunt 360 Box has the potential to revolutionize the way shipments move.
Do you see this, the JB Hunt 360 Box as an extension for intermodal, for the rails?
That's
going to be huge.
We see 360 Box, they're really the ability to, if you think about what's happening at a customer location,
right?
If you just look at that, there's so many different colors of trailers and the management of what has to happen. Now you replace that with less complexity. So more JB Hunt 360 boxes, less live loading, less live unloading.
Yep.
It creates more efficiency for them. So anywhere we can do that, Mark, we're really interested in that space. Now, we haven't gone into intermodal in that yet because, you know, we really think intermodal is an efficient way to move goods. And we think if we can talk to our customers about intermodal, that we can help them see how they can move shipments on the highway and it be an advantage for them. And obviously, it's a huge advantage for drivers because it's a local job that's regular for them as well.
Where do you see the company in 5 years? Where do you see technology in 5 years at JB Hunt?
Wow, that is a fantastic question. We get asked that a lot, and I'm going to give you the chief commercial officer's response to that. I'm sure our CFO or CEO has something different. You know, but I think we will be so consultative with our customers that we're able to solve for our customers any type of shipment that they want to do. And we're going to allow our customers really take us on a growth journey of what makes sense for them, what makes sense for our employees, our vendors, and our shareholders. And I think we're pretty open to that. You know, we tend to be known as modal agnostic, which just means we're fairly indifferent. We want to solve for the best way to move goods. If we can think of it that way, Mark, I will tell you, I see us being a very large organization. So I think we are just getting started as a company. I think we will always be driver-centric. I think we'll always be customer-focused. And I think we will be technology-driven. And those three things, when we operationally execute with excellence, boy, I think we're going to do some big things over the next 5 years.
You know what this sounds like, Shelley, that, you know, the young people that are out there listening to this, when they hear phrases like getting into the ground floor, great opportunities, technology-driven type of a company, this is going to open up so many doors to bring new people into the industry. Do you think once they get the messaging about all of the collaborative and the great platforms that are being developed, they're going to say, you know what? Trucking transportation is for me. What do you think?
Do you know what they're going to say? Transportation is the new sexy.
right.
You know,
right.
When I was in school and somebody told me they were going to work in trucking, now my papa was a truck driver, so I knew what that meant,
sure.
But I had no idea there was a job, you know, that I could actually do there. But now, Mark, I get stopped all the time with people saying, wow, you work in a logistics and supply chain company. You work in a trucking company. You know, so people are interested. And to your point, technology, that really opens up the minds of people that are interested in starting a career inside an organization because it's even a new added area. Not just at JB Hunt, but just across the industry.
Yes,
we're advancing so much that it's actually, if you looked at our job applicants, you know, that's one of the reasons we're growing.
Yes.
As a company, we have people that are interested in coming to work inside our organization for the direction that we're headed.
I'm just about out of time. We've gone through 30 minutes here on the program. It's flown. And what great information. Shelley, I want to thank you for spending a few minutes with us. I do want to get websites, social media, phone numbers. How can folks find out more about what you guys
super do? Easy for us, jbhunt.com. You're going to see it straight there. If you want to be a carrier, want to be a customer, you can connect right there. And if you'd like a job, jbhunt.jobs.
Outstanding. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank
Appreciate you.
You. Always good to see you. That is Shelley Simpson, guys. And she's the Executive Vice President and Chief Commercial Officer, President of Highway Services at JB Hunt Transport.